Hello everyone, welcome back to Train Simulator. So we're back in the Class 143 Railbus, and it's no longer the Cardiff Commuter Carriage, because as you can tell, we're not actually in Cardiff anymore. So we've been, I think we've come from Cheltenham Spa, or are we going there? I forget. Let's find out our instructions, shall we? Oh, we can't because the game's paused. Excellent. It's on pause because, once again, it is campaign mode, so everything I do here matters. So what we're going to do is we're going to get right to it, I guess. Why not? So F1, we've got to pick up people from here. So let's do that just now. We'll open the doors. Meanwhile, we'll get set up. So the reverser needs to be into the forward position. We'll unset the AWS, we'll get the lights on, I think I've set them using the command. Yes, okay. So, let's see where we're going. So, yes, we're heading into Cardiff, from Cheltenham Spa, I think it was. We've taken over from another driver in what is a very, very, very loud train. The rain is going, so I had to activate the window wipers. Got two buzzes, which is a good thing. Wait, where is the window wipers? Wipers. Okay, V, right, fair enough. Thankfully I can remember it. So, we're off brake. Let's give us a little bit of acceleration here. Where is the window wipers? It's not that. Is there a button for it? it must be one of the ones here. No? Alright, anyway, doesn't matter. So we're full speed here. Oh no, we're not, because we've got a... We have a station ahead, which is where we're going to be stopping at, so I'll just kill the throttle for the moment. We'll get ready on the brakes. So at the moment, we're currently set to be 10 seconds late, which is not ideal. Alrighty. So yes, this is kind of the reverse journey of the journey that we did in the Sprinter. So we're going to be coming here, and we're going way too fast. Maybe not emergency. Yeah. We lose points for drive quality, which is a little bit. Wow, this thing can stop on a dime, Christ. So it does have a G sensor in it. So if I do. Right, okay. I didn't realise this thing stopped as fast as it did. And that has, in turn, made us actually quite a little bit more late. Oh dear! Right, anyway, so let's, we'll do stage one braking, so we're looking for a two or three car stop. There's no two, so there's a three car stop, so that's as good a place as any, I suppose. Right, okay, doors are open. There's no driver reminder appliance in this, so we don't have to worry about that. I'm still looking for a window wiper. Normally there's at least a button for it. Engine stop, engine test, that's kind of what we want. Okay. Two buzzes. Let's go. So, we've released the brake. We'll bring this to stage two. and we don't have another stop for 15 minutes, so it's going to be a case of regulating it. We can see that we're off. They're taking us off the fast line into the snow line. The snow line? The slow line. So let's gun it full speed. We watch this train come bolting on through. Oh no, it looks like it's stopping actually. Because it's going pretty slowly. Great Western Railroad! Anyway, we're gonna gun it at full speed, so where is it we're coming off? So it's this little part here that we've been kinked to come off at, into the down slow. That's fine. Yeah. Listen to the sound of that engine. Now we need to watch, so we're not actually at maximum throttle. Now we're at maximum throttle. And we're actually set to be 4 minutes late. So the downside, we're now down to... horrible noise. The downside of being on the slow lane is we're about to come into a 40 mile an hour restriction, which is a pain in the trombone. So that's the noise telling us to watch out for a sign, and the sign is that we're coming into a 40 mile an hour zone. So what we'll do, we'll just get ready. And we know this thing can brake on a dime. So we'll wait until we're at this signal. Just do it now. So we're on step one braking for the moment. I think that'll do it. No. So I'm just playing the throttle, the brake a little bit, making sure that we get to this. So now what we want to do, we're on level running and we're going to be like this for at least a while. So I just want to try and get a good throttle point. So stage three will... Please don't go to one. Crap. Okay, so stage two it is. Little freight train over to the left, to the right. Oh, it's one of the new ones. Class 70s.
Chirp chirp!
Brand new freight wagon against a good old 20-year-old Railbus. Okay, so we're going to be looking to try and make up any time that we can, because at the moment we are running 3.5 minutes late, which is more than acceptable. So what we'll do... Oh, happy noise. So, okay. We're just to keep it like this for the moment. Okay. So we're starting to get actually a little bit sluggish, so I'm just, yeah. Like I say, it's just about playing the throttle a little bit so that we can try and push. You're allowed a one mile an hour tolerance, so we're going to push that tolerance for all it's worth. So 40 miles an hour running isn't exactly great. It's actually quite a straight railway, so I don't know why they would consider it to require such a slow speed. Anyway, it doesn't matter. It is what it is. And as you... Oh shit. We slightly overcooked it. we overcooked it. Great. So we lost 17 more points for speeding, which is a bit crud. But yeah, as you can see, this 1 mile an hour difference is starting to work wonders. So we've already clawed back. We've already clawed back 30 seconds on the time. So we're only 210 seconds late. We need to call that down as much as we can. Alrighty. Oh! Now where are we going? Because we're not staying on this line, we're going off to the left. Ah, crap, did it again. It's fine, we're going uphill now, so... Well, we're going ever so slightly uphill, but we lost another elven fucking hill. So, as I touched on this last time, if we were in a bogey train, this would not be happening. The only reason it's happening is because this is rigid axles, so even the slightest corner will get that jittery noise, which is where the inside of the wheels... So, I can't remember if I talked about this before, but the composition of a railway wheel, so you've got the rails on the inside, well, you've got the rails here, and then on the inside you've got the wheel, and then you've got, this basically stops you from derailing, and then you've got a... you've got the wheel that sits on top of it. So if you're going around the corner too tight, that part that sits on the inside of the rail scrapes against it, and that's the noise that you're hearing. You do get it sometimes in bogeyed trains, but you need to be going quite fast and going around quite some bit of a corner. Whereas in this, like, even the slightest corner, it'll just go, ooh, cool. A level crossing with nobody at it. I'm actually just wondering, did we perchance miss a whistle board? No, we didn't. That's fine. So anyway, we've clawed back another minute, so we're now down to 120 seconds of being late. So that's almost within tolerance now. Crap! I'm not doing very well for not speeding today. I think that's us now lost at least 100 points through speeding, which might cost me my gold star. That would be most awkward. Do we have passenger views in the Railbus? Oh, we do. So yeah, quite basic accommodation. Hello. Not seating, it's not really accommodation. For God's sake! I'm just the worst today. Out of curiosity, if we leave it on stage 2, where does it sit? See, that's quite slow. Alright, we'll bring it up a bit. Oh no. I moved the accelerator the wrong way. If I'd been doing it properly, I would have noticed that. Okay, so it's a rainy day in Wales. I wonder if we have a problem. Because we're starting to slow down. Even though we're accelerating. We're not going uphill. Choo-choo! Right, we're not going uphill, but we're losing speed. There we go. Right, that woke it up, didn't it? Now we are going uphill a bit. Okay, I'm just going to kill off the accelerator because we're going to start dropping down the hill in a second. So we've got another train coming towards us. We're just going to watch here. Right, that's braked us more than enough. Thank you. And yet we're still losing speed. Something's not right in this train. And I don't know what. Okay, right, whatever it was is sorted now. So that's fine. Right, okay. So we're now progressing and we're now within 60 seconds of our target time. And we're only 4.5 minutes away from the station, even though we've bled all of our points to speeding penalties. So now that we at least know what we're looking for, we're actually going to have to watch out for this. Because it starts going slightly downhill. Yeah, so we can see that. So just stage one us for a moment. Yeah, okay, this is fine. And we're back up to 60. Where is it? Where's the 60 board? Crap, I can't see it. But it says 60 mile an hour now, so let's punch it. However, there is a speed board up ahead, but that might be for left only. So anyway, we're going as fast as our little crappy engine can manage. So angry noise is coming, I think. No? Oh yeah, we don't have a feather, so no. It's 10 miles an hour for anyone going off to the left, which we are not. We're green signal, which means we are cleared on through. And the game is obviously on hemorrhaging frame rates, which is fine. This is not on our track, so it's quite difficult to spot that at a distance. But in the UK, train drivers need to go through a course which basically tells them, like, is that signal on this line, or is that signal part of this line, or is it part of a road network or something? Which is all pretty interesting. Anyway, we've got more speed changes coming up, but we're nearing 60 miles an hour, so we'll just ease off for the moment. So we're green. It looks like that high speed train's been brought down. There's a teensy tiny 40 mile an hour marker board. So I think we'll gently stage one us just now. Now within 30 seconds of target. Okay, is this gonna be happy noise? Yes. Okay, fine. So, 40 mile an hour board is here, we're gonna make that easy, so ease off the brakes. Currently scheduled to be 25 seconds and closing. Hear that jittering noise again as we go around a slight bend. I'm actually a wee bit worried that this signal might be for us. No, it's not. It's for the next one, right? That's fine. Okay. So it looks like they're pulling it into Newport as the frame rates really bottom out in the rain. Oh, 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 that's horrible. Ha, ha, ha. Okay. So... we'll put us to stage one for the moment. We'll bleed speed off. We're within 13 seconds of the target time. Okay, let's just ease off the brake a moment. Okay, so we're going to platform one, as we can tell by the feather marker. So platform one is a left turn here at 20 miles an hour, which is what we're on, so that's fine. We're now looking for the three car stop, wherever the Ekin that might be. And a little bit of texture bark. more accustomed to seeing that in GTA than we are in Train Simulator. So here's all the people coming towards the train. I can't see a three car stop, so we'll probably just aim for the sprinter stop. So we'll put it to stage two to bring us in. Oh, we're gonna miss it, I think. No, we've got plenty of time. Right then, door control, open. So we were 12 seconds late in the end. So our passengers are going to disembark and everyone else is going to get on. Yeah, I don't know why they're all walking down there. They've now got a long jog to get to the train before I pull away. I ain't waiting for these people. Got the timing board. Do not leave bags unattended. Oh, this is cool. Right, so now we're waiting. Wait for two buzz. Ah, they do have a driver's reminder appliance. Okay, great. Well, we've got our two buzzes anyway, so let's ease off the brake. So we got a timeliness bonus again, which is pretty good because we were running on time. 12 seconds is not bad, given that 2 hours late is kind of not unexpected in British railing ways. Right, so reminder for the next platform. In fact, the next platform's our terminus, so we can't anyway. But there is a driver's reminder appliance. And we were given a green signal, because this signal is for this platform. Well, this line. Right. That is okay. So you remember earlier on in the journey I was okay, we're up to 40. Earlier on in the journey I was discussing about how that we were still on stage 3 throttle, but instead of keeping us at like 39 miles an hour, it was much, much lower than that. I realise now it was because we were in second gear. It was in second gear, that was why we were, because we're at stop now. Right, let's get my words in order. We're now at throttle stage 3, and we're only at 21 miles an hour because we're still in first gear. That is why. So, let's just, let's pick us up a bit. So if we go to stage 7, I don't know what speed that'll take us to, we will find out momentarily. Probably be 36 miles an hour, I imagine. 36.1! Ah, I've been playing Train Sim for far too long. Anyway, we'll bring it up to 8. Okay, so we've now gone into second gear. Fuck's sake. We're on downhill as well. So just watching our speed a little bit. Oh, that's pretty interesting. Oh no, it's I thought it was an abandoned tunnel. I didn't actually see a track going into it. Anywho. So we're back on board. So we've got 17 minutes to go until the car lift platform, and we're currently running at 102 seconds of delay, which is just within tolerance, but we'll see what we can do with it. Let's bring it up to stage 3. In fact, we're about to hit into a 60, which will be helpful for us. But yes, so stage 7 in first gear only takes you to 36 miles an hour. You upshift at 38 miles an hour, and so stage 3 will take us to about 41, 42 miles an hour, which is just over what we need, sadly. But it is what it is. We've gone down a gear, which is why stage 3 isn't working for us. So yeah, you hear the upshift, it's at 39 miles an hour in this train. and we are into 60 mile an hour territory here. So let's gun it for all we're worth. Here's one of the trains. I think this is the train that we'll be driving next time, or have we got one more to do? I can't remember. Because there's four in this campaign before you go over to the new train campaign. Okay, right, well. So we're now making good time, which is great. We need to make sure not to get any more speeding penalties that might reduce what we can do. But we're now gunning at full throttle through the Welsh countryside. The double yellow is for the upline fast. We're on the upline. No, we're on the downline. Yeah, we're on the downline slow. So they're on the that's a downline fast. Ooh, okay. Oh come on! How are we speeding? Stage 5. Stage 4. Alright, we'll keep it on stage 4, see where we go. At the moment, 57 seconds late. That's not bad, that's tolerable. So, so this is kind of part of the whole package. The rail buses have a much smaller engine. Because there's not a great deal of room for an engine if we look in the place. Train engines are kind of located in the part that sits below, in between the two axles. Ordinarily, it would be in between the new bogies. The bogies usually give just a little bit of extra height, which means extra room for more powerful engines. However, the axles are much lower, so yeah, not really possible. This train doesn't have a first class section. How shameful. Oh! Looks like the high speed train's been stopped up ahead. We can just see its tail light. I do indeed wonder why that is. Let us hae a gander. I'm going past it now. Where is it? Oh, sure, we can see its taillights. Ah, no, we can, but it's not stopped at all. It's just going full speed. And it's in fact not. It's a commuter train. It's a failed rail bus, but they're on a faster track than us. I feel offended. I feel like we're second class citizens. Maybe that rail bus is all first class. But the high speed train's obviously gone past. Gone walloping past them. I also noticed that it's saying it's going to Cardiff Central, which is where we're going, but it says we're going to Maesteg. No idea where that is. You can point to any part of Wales and tell me that's Maesteg and I would believe you. Alrighty, so we're just watching our speed a little bit here within 15 seconds of timeliness. And there is a friggity freight train! Choo 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 choo! The sound of industry! Welsh industry! So, oh crap, we've got a slowdown coming up ahead. So we'll just squeeze what we can out. Okay. So we're on 60 miles an hour. Is this the warning board? Nope. 20 miles an hour if we're going to the left, but I keep zooming in and zooming out. You can tell by the shunting signal that it is unlit, which means we are staying on the main line. If it was lit and it was red, that would indicate that we were going onto the side track and we did not have permission to enter. If it was lit and it's white, it means that we're going onto the side track. Oh, that one. And yeah. But we're not going into the side track. Woohoo! So this is going to be an angry board, so let's get ready on the AWS. We're going to see it come in to view. Warning, 40 miles an hour speed limit ahead, so angry noise. You've got 2.7 seconds to hit that buzzer, otherwise your train comes to a crashing halt. Well, crashing is maybe the wrong word. It's a safety measure, but it's a safety device. Your train comes to a safe halt, albeit a rather expeditious one. So let's begin the process of slowing this train down. We'll put it on stage 2 a sec. Oh no, we can't reach it. Okay, stage 2. Oh no, we're speeding. It's fine. I think we've lost about 1,400,000 points to speeding at the moment. How are we still speeding? Oh god, we're on a downhill slope, that's why. Whoops. Okay, stage 1 braking. Braking complete. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to punt it into second gear. Okay. So we're now in second gear, which is kind of ideal. Looks like we've got another one of the new flashy trains. Not like the old sheds that we're driving. Theirs is much nicer. So we now have a signal change coming up. So let's see if it changes as we get closer. How close are we? No, we're still 10 minutes away from Cardiff Central, and we're not stopping anywhere else, I don't think. No. So Cardiff Central is the next and last destination for this here commuter carriage. So we're about to get an angry noise. So AWS is gone. So two lights means the signal two ahead of this one is at red. Now that can be a temporary thing or it can be a permanent thing. Sounds like there's another train coming up behind us. The Great Western Railroad! So they are off ski at this moment in time. Excellent. So signal change only for those going left. So they've got their slow train ahead. Actually, do you know what it'll be? So I'll take the angry noise. So what I think is happening here, oh no, it's two ahead, right, yes. So I think what's happening here is they've punted the commuter carriage into the slow line. And now we are, yes, so that's exactly what's happened. So while the train tracks reset themselves back to normal, that signal stays at red, but it's now gone green. So they're continuing on the fast line, and the commuter carriage has now been moved onto the slow line. So we're now chasing yellows. So we just need to make sure we're going roughly at the same speed as it. But the difference is they've got a green run, and we're going to have to be monitoring our advanced warning system the whole time. So let's just go ahead and catch up. I love the teeny wee signals. In fact, we're down into first gear again, aren't we? So let's punt it back up. Drop. So as soon as there's the drop, we can just, yeah. So they've got a cool signal here. I wonder if I'll be able to show you this as it happens. So they've got a repeater signal. I don't think I've ever been able to show a repeater signal working before. So if we just watch ahead, we had an AWS, but that's fine. So you can see the signal's yellow, or it's two yellows, which is effectively a green as far as the repeater's gone, and now it's gone from diagonal to flat, which means the signal's at red, and sure enough we can see it is at red. So we're still chasing yellows here, so angry noise. So they are going pretty slow, actually. Curious about why. Oh. Apparently we're approaching Cardiff Central already. Fair enough. I wasn't expecting that. We're not due there for another 5.5 minutes. Red signal. Hang on. We need to brake the train. Oh, we're now onto yellow. So we're going to get an angry noise here. So push that. So we need to keep an eye out for that. So we're now going to get another angry noise because it's warning us that we're going down to 15 miles an hour. So just wait for the magnet. You'll see it now. There we go. On ball. So what we'll do is we'll put it into stage one. So we're gonna get noise. So we've actually got stoppage. So we're gonna bring us to a halt. So this is the problem that we've got, is we've actually arrived too early. So the Great Western Railroad train, they're going to platform 3, and this train's just coming from there. So even though there's a space for us, I suspect we're due on this platform here. This platform. But there's kind of rail buses up the wazoo at the moment, and commuter trains just every which place. So let's just bring ourselves forward. So we're kind of got a bit of a waiting game actually at the moment. Oh, one thing I wanted to see is actually just how close that wall is. The answer is exceptionally. So all we're doing here is just getting as close to the signal as we can manage, so when the time comes for us to go, we can just put it into gear and go. This looks like it's an uphill. It's quite because we've got this place, the thing coming down. Yeah, that's close enough. Yeah, because we've got the line up to Glasgow Queen Street to Cardiff Queen Street coming downhill, it makes it look like we're on a downhill, but it makes it look like we're on an uphill, but we're in fact not. So we're now kind of stuck here because we made up some good time, so all that speeding has kind of shot us in the trumpet in the end. So the Cardiff commuter carriage over here has now left, so we might be on a yellow light. We are. So we've now been given our permission to go to platform 4. So we'll release the brakes and we will gingerly maneuver us in. Ooh. So everybody is moving off. How's this train? That train's still there for a little while. It's a little bit unusual, but alrighty. So okay. So we're limited to 15 miles an hour at the moment. We're going to head into platform 4. Quite an uphill now, all of a sudden. Right, so we're coming into platform 4 to end our adventure on the Welsh Railways. So what we look for here is the 3-car stop, which I am not spying, if I were perfectly honest. So we'll just stop somewhere around the middle. So let's take the accelerator off and let's now put us to stage 2 braking for the final time. And seeing as we know how to do it now, we will do the last stop properly. So we've come to a stop, driver's reminder appliance on, and doors open. A German company. Fair enough. Alright. So because we're terminating, it's going to take a while to get absolutely everybody and their dog off of my train. This is the subway. Everybody in the Great Western Railroad is chillaxed. I wonder, what stopping board are they at? Yeah, okay, they just kind of guess where it stopped. We're around here, and yeah, so this is kind of the conclusion of our Cardiff commuter service. Not a local commuter, but actually kind of a semi-express commuter type thing. So what we'll do is we'll wait until we get the buzz, and then we will get to find out how we've done. Very simple trains, but here we go. The service will continue down to Mistaig, but you are no longer required. Let's find out how you did. Yes, let's. Did I get 3? I did. Yes, I got the gold stars. So we basically got the maximum number of timeliness penalties that we could get, so we weren't late anywhere. But unfortunately, that was courtesy of a whole bunch of speeding penalties and one driving quality where we triggered the emergency brake for the shiz and giggles. So that is the end of this adventure on the Welsh Railways. So oh no, I did get silver. So yes, when we come back, we do have we've got an hour-long adventure in winter time as part of the class 158, and then we're onwards and upwards. So I'll see you for that adventure next time on Train Simulator 2017. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.